Vive le français! Bonjour chers amis, aujourd'hui je vous parle du vin, je vous parle du coupon des taxes. Alors qu'est-ce que c'est le coupon des taxes? C'est ça, le coupon des taxes. So what is it? This is the tax coupon. The tax coupon. On it you can see Marianne. You can see this face is the face of Marianne, which is the symbol of France, the symbol of the value of France, liberté, égalité, fraternité. Freedom, equality, brotherhood. And Marianne, you can see her on the tax. So sometimes you have to pay the tax and there will be this Marianne. So it means that this wine has to pay the tax first before it's being sold. And this is very important because le coupon des taxes gives us many information about the wine. So something important that it tells us here, you can read by yourself, it's written récoltant. Récoltant. Can you see récoltant? Récoltant. Récoltant. And here we have also récoltant. Récoltant. So what does récoltant mean? Récoltant means is the producer who produces the wine will also harvest the wine. Il va récolter. Récolter, it means he picks up the grapes, he produces the grape by himself. So this guy is producing the wine himself and then he bottles it and he sells it. On the contrary, you have some other coupon des taxes, for instance this one, where you don't have récoltant, but you have N. N means négociant. So what is négociant? Négociant, une maison de négoce. Une maison de négoce, it's someone who is going to buy the product for someone else and sell it back to the end consumer. So he's doing a little bit the go-between. In fact, when you look at this, it's strange because this is a famous champagne, very famous champagne, and you see négociant. Négociant. So it means this guy doesn't produce the champagne himself. He just go and find the place and buy from the producer. And then he probably put inside the bottle, or he already buy the bottles, and then he sells them back. So une maison de négoce. In Bordeaux, there used to be many maisons de négoce. Maison de négoce for the wine. They would buy the wine in bulk, in big quantity. Then they would storage it in some place. They would keep it for many years. And they can make a lot of money this way, because the wine value will increase. So some négociants, certains négociants, they want to try and buy the maximum wine and they are doing a little bit a bet. They are betting. They say, okay, I'm going to buy this wine because this year was a good year and the wine is a good wine and I think this brand will grow a lot. I'm going to keep it a few years and I will sell it back. So les négociants, they have the big warehouse and in this warehouse they can storage the wine and traditionally there was this warehouse a little bit everywhere and we can see sometimes it's called maison de vin ou caviste. And they will have this big warehouse and they will keep the wine for several years and sell it back after. And now these, they have négociants that are very big companies and they will even have warehouse in many countries, in Tokyo, in Shanghai, in many places around the world. And they will buy the wine in bulk and they will sell it back. What happens quite often is you have one producer. For some of his wine, he will be the producer, and so for some other wine, he's not going to be the producer. For some other wine, he's going to be négociant. Okay? For instance, let me show you this one here. A famous wine, it's Mouton Cadet, Rothschild. This wine, you can look at this, you see N, négociant. So it means this brand, they don't produce the wine themselves, they just buy it from someone else. And in fact, when you look at Rothschild is a very big group. I think it belongs to LVMH. I'm not sure. It might not belong to LVMH, but I think it belongs to LVMH, LV group. And so anyway, some of the wine that is the top quality wine, he will produce by himself. So for some of the wine, he will be récoltant, okay? That's for his top quality wine. And then for the other wine, he will just be négociant. Why is that? Because he has a very famous brand. So when you have a very famous brand, what you say, you do skim the market. So you have one product that you produce yourself, and all the rest, you're just making money on it. So you just put the logo, Mouton Cadet, Mouton Cadet, Mouton Cadet, Mouton Cadet, and you can make more money this way. So my suggestion to you is don't buy when it is négociant. Don't buy it. Just buy the wine that are récoltant. Because usually when it's récoltant, you know that this wine is produced directly by the person who makes this bottle. So if you compare the quality and the price, price quality, it will always be a little bit higher. For this one, I'm not saying that it's bad quality wine. It's good wine, but you will pay more. You will pay more because you're going to pay for the brand. And quality-wise, it's not as good. Quality wine. And these guys, the négociants, what do? The négociants, they take care of the label. They take care of the packaging. They will add value to the product. And they will also add value to the product by keeping it for some years and then selling it back. That's the role. And they will add value to the product by putting a nice label, by putting a nice logo, a nice brand, and this and that. So I always advise you to buy récoltant. If you look at the champagne, you can see most of these bottles, they are all Négociant. Négociant is a very famous brand. And, if you look at the champagne, you see all these brands, they are all Négociant. So Négociant for this one, which is Mott et Chandon, Négociant. If you look at this one, what else? Mott et Chandon, Négociant. This one, that's Veuve Clicquot. Veuve Clicquot is also Négociant. Veuve Clicquot is also Négociant. So you can wonder why it is always Négociant. Why it's always Négociant? But it makes sense because at the time you would have some people. They would just buy from. They would buy and select the wine and select the highest quality wine. So these guys is also Négociant. You see, Veuve Clicquot is also Négociant. They would select the wine from the pure producer and they would say, okay, this champagne wine is high quality champagne and it's suitable for the Emperor of Russia. So it's suitable. So they are not going to be the producer, they're only going to be the Négociant. If you look at this one, for instance, that's also Négociant. You know, this one, champagne, Marquis Santé, you look, Négociant. Okay, they're all Négociant. So for the champagne, it's a little bit, and in Champagne, il y a des grandes maisons de négociants. There are some big house of négociants. And this house of négociants have been around for hundreds of years. Okay. Merci, au revoir.